up? AJ back here at E3 2010. I'm on the EA Sports floor in their booth. But Rammer here is about to take me behind closed doors where they show the real crazy stuff. I mean, I don't know what we're about to see. Follow me.
Let's go.
We're talking NHL 11 here. We're behind closed doors at E3, but a lot of people have gotten a chance to take a look at it. The new Broken Six system, the new physics checking. What has everybody thought so far?
Yeah, you know what, the reaction's been really, really good. You know, we talk about all the new features we put in each and every year, but the real proof is when people get their hands on it and they play it. You know, I tell people that are standing in the background watching me demo, you got to get your hands on it. Get your hands on, you know, one of the things that, you know, I wouldn't say surprised us, but kind of surprised us was, you know, when we put the physics in, we knew it was going to make the game look different, play different, but we didn't expect it to change the feel of the game. So people picking it up and they, you know, they're saying it feels completely different. I feel like when I hit somebody with Char or a big guy, I'm driving through them. They see the way the stick-on-stick contacts happen, where the pucks bounce differently. So the feel of the game's completely changed. You know, the real-time physics really just changed the foundation of our gameplay. It's going to be, the future is endless for us now with the engine as a base.
Yeah, I got a chance to play it a little bit myself up at EAC a few weeks ago, and it has, you know, been tweaked even more since then. The checking system is just amazing. You really do have to feel it. I mean, the way the guy's legs bend underneath them, it's completely realistic. What's the craziest hit you've seen so far?
Man, you know what? I can say this before I start. I think we've broken every single rule about demoing at E3 here, because we get something crazy. Again, with the real-time physics, everything's unscripted. We don't know what's going to happen. I'll be demoing with people, and I'll stop them. I'll, you know, start calling the guys over. We'll huddle around. You got to see it. I'm sorry. I apologize for stopping the demo, but I got to show everybody this, because we're seeing stuff here. We've probably seen 20, 25 things in the last 3 days that we've never seen before throughout the entire development. You know, guys' legs getting bent up, guys getting hit over the boards, our legs getting caught on the boards. Dino was demoing the other day and just had a pass across crease, hit a broken stick line on the ice, the puck went up over the goalie's shoulder and in the net. Just unbelievable moments, and we have to stop and show people this, because this is stuff that we don't see. That, you know, when we talk about open-ended gameplay, that's what we're talking about. We're talking about these wow moments that just happen, not because we put them there, we just put the pieces there and let them happen.
Yeah, this new mentality, I mean, it's the same thing with NBA Elite and FIFA and Madden and NCAA as well with locomotion. And it seems like everybody's going for, you know, you want people to experience these moments, make their highlights themselves, not script them for them. And it really seems to be working so far, right?
Yeah, I mean, we want to model the real, two things. We want to model the real world, and we want to give people the tools to create all these moments. So if something happens in the sport, let's give people the tools to make that stuff happen, and then use real world physics, just use the real world, what happened in the real world, and just see what happens. And that's what people want, and that's where, you know, I think all sports teams are going to go to. You look back in the day when we said we want something like broken sticks, we would say, okay, on that fifth shot, let's break a stick and have that guy skate straight to the bench. No, we want to use, you know, we want to be dynamic, to true to the real world, and that's, you know, I think all our gameplay, all the games at EAC, at EA in general, are going to go towards that just open-ended, dynamic, kind of organic gameplay where anything can happen, and, you know, you get moments that you never see before. The greatest thing about this year is we're going to have videos on EA Sports World this year, so someone's going to get something that no one else will ever see and ever get themselves.
Very cool. Rammer, when's the game coming out?
September 7th.
September 7th. Be sure to pick it up. Make your own highlights. Thanks, Rammer.
Thank you.